California. Here's Hoppy now with another new story.
We call this story the Band of the Blackton Den. You never have to carry trouble with Blackton Den. The town always has plenty of it waiting for you. Lay on the line that separates Texas from Oklahoma. Part in one state, part in the other, with its friendship as divided as its laws. It was a bleak town, a brooding town, and its mood was mirrored on the face of a middle-aged woman who stood outside the Texas saloon. Until suddenly she twisted away as if running from the violence brewing within.
Kill a piano, Eddie. Got things to say.
More of the same, Cameron. You better strap on a pistol. Because I'm not going to take it.
You don't have to take it now. There's ways of checking things without using guns.
Yes. You're planning on that, haven't you, Cameron? You've been hungering to use those big muscles of yours.
Ape that you are. You got a reputation for being good with your own muscles as well as your newspaper. I see. Why don't we go out in the street right now and settle with you?
Any news? I got a feeling that the hottest beat don't want no part of anything like that.
You think you're well supported, Mr. Dameron? Full fire on the one side of you, struck blonde on the other. But you're wearing a .45, folks. You're going to have to use it if you make any more noise like that.
Oh, yeah?
Well, I didn't.
Oh. Yeah, I didn't use my gun.
We know you're good with a gun, Mr. Hardy. But I always heard you was good with your fist, too. Of course, that might have just been talk. Talk's cheap, ain't it?
All right, Dameron, you get your way. Let's go outside and settle this.
Thank you, Mr. Hardison. I've been waiting a long time to hear you say them words.
I swear, Hoppy, you must be plumb slowing down. Here we ride 60 miles to get to town, and you head straight for the post office.
The main reason we came in, wasn't it? So we could mail this letter. I'm going in to get it done.
Well, is it ain't Hopalong, Cassidy in California?
Hiya.
Hi, Lyde.
Hi. Ouch, what the blazes is that? Almost took me in my ear.
Better watch your step, California. That's a keg of blasting powder.
Blasting powder? What's it doing here?
Oh, that stubborn old moss pack of the clam thieves brought it in. Wanted me to ship it to Elby firm. When I said the U.S. mail don't handle no explosives, he like to flew through the roof. Then he walked out and left it here. Guess he figures if he leaves it long enough, I'll get in and handle it for him. He's going to find out the U.S. mail is just as stubborn as he is.
Ain't you taking chances leaving that stuff around?
No, ain't nothing going to happen to blasting powder unless somebody sets it off. I ain't worrying none.
Well, you better live with it. What's that you're open?
Reward poster. Just come in. What was it you wanted, Hoppy?
A stamp for this letter.
Oh, huh? Here you are. Face it on, drop it in the slot there.
I see that poster. Fella looks like a dude.
Don't sound like no dude, though. Listen to this. Wanted for post office robbery. James Carlisle, age 26. Armed and dangerous. Shoots left-handed. Is fast and deadly. Send information to United States Postal Inspector, Dodge City, Kansas.
$500 reward. That ain't bad picking. If you win for reward.
No, it ain't. Here, California. Let me get by you so as I can tack this thing up on that board there.
How's Dan Sebastian, Lise? He's still marshal on this side of the line?
Yeah, he's still marshal. With Steve Lewis running the law in another portion of town. And they ain't no better friends than they ever was. You know, I always claim we'll never have no peace here till we go whole hog into either Texas or Oklahoma. Killer can burn a man down on one side of the street and get away from the law by just stepping over to the other.
Well, like it like it is. Ain't no town like Blackton Bend for excitement. Hey, come on, Poppy, let's go, sir.
Well, another day.
You closing up, Lars?
Yep, I'm closing up. Once I throw that bolt, nobody else comes in. Even the president himself couldn't get that rule broken. Well, I got some work to finish up here. So long, boys.
So long, Lars.
Hopalong, Cassidy. I knew I saw you ride into town.
Hello, Mrs. Fife. We were just...
You're a friend of Matt Hardesty's, ain't you?
Matt Hardesty? Sure, I'm his friend.
Well, you better help him, then. He's been talked into a fight with Newt Damron. A fist fight.
A fist fight? That's only a couple of weeks since Hardesty was thrown from a horse.
Don't I know it? But those men don't seem to care. And if you don't help him out of it, that Newt Damron will just beat him to death.
our story, The Bandit of Blackton Bend. In Blackton Bend, Matt Cottesby, publisher of the local newspaper, stands in danger of being badly beaten by a brutal Newt Damlin. Hockey, knowing that Cottesby isn't physically fit for a fight, hurries to his plan A.
Holy sausage, bro. Would anybody like to bet on Mr. Hardesty's chance? Never mind the speaker, Salmon. Get your fists up. No hurry, Mr. Madden. I ain't of a mind to hurry with you at all. I'm going to take care of your eyes first. I'm going to work on the rest of that pretty face of yours. I ain't going to be in no hurry about it. Let's stop applauding and get started.
No use asking him to do that, man. Salmon would rather gloat than eat. Wouldn't you?
Yes, sir. What do you want?
He set on having this fight, Matt.
It isn't my choice, Hoppy. Damlin's the one who set on it.
Newt can be talked out of things like that. Can't you, Newt?
Stay out of this, Cassidy.
Artist is my friend. There's no business fighting anyone but his fist. Matt was thrown from a horse a couple of weeks ago, and he's not over it yet.
Hey, now, ain't that real sympathetic? Maybe you'd like to take his place.
I'm not begging for the chance, Newt. This is mighty tough for any man you fight. Now, for fun, not for brute.
Good, clean air.
Oh, excuse me, ma'am. I just wasn't watching where I was going.
Yes, it was, Huffy.
Hello, Mr. Hardesty. I'm really sorry about
talking to you today. I'm sure it's all right. Any car life? It's a couple on cash.
How do you do, ma'am?
Keep my son around, maybe, Huffy.
Half an hour ago. That's a Colorado saloon.
You used to think that you're a better bet than what we want.
I can help.
You know that, Jim Rock Country, Hoppy. That's where we think he's hiding out.
How do you know?
Well, Jim got a letter through to describing where he is. Mr. Hardesty recognized the spot from my description of it. If you could find Jim for me, tell him to come home, I'd be everlasting grateful. I'm afraid that if Jim keeps on the run, he might do something
because I've been playing the reformer a little too heavily. Maybe I've been stubborn about it. I began to realize that reform editorials can cost the paper friends and business.
I guess that stuff is sort of like giving people medicine. Something they ought to have, but they hate like blazes to take it.
Yeah, I see what you mean. I've been impatient. I wanted to see it come in my time, but...
Oh! Good heavens, what was that?
Here, let me help you up. You all right, sir?
I'm all right, but that's an explosion, Cassidy.
Hey, Pete, what happened? Post office. Just blew all the smithereens.
Post office? And nice Watkins hasn't been by on his way home. He must have been in it.
Hopalong Cassidy and the Bandit of Blackton Bend. A heavy explosion has just jarred Blackton Bend, bringing everyone in town panting to the scene. Now a mass of smoldering embers served as the total remains of what had once been the United States Post Office.
How about it, Marshal? What's the story on Lige Watkins?
Well, it's bad. Waiting to put his shipment of money on the stage.
And he's in there. He's in there.
Well, found it, Marshal.
The body?
Yeah. The old Lige, all right.
Oh. You better take Mrs. Stripe away.
Tom Levitt recognized that altitude. Lige always wore in his watch chain.
How about the box?
No sign of it. We went through them embers like rats to a grain bin. What's this about a box, Marshal?
A metal chest was scheduled to go out on tonight's stage.
Money in it?
About 10,000 in bills.
What's that, Marshal? What's that about money?
Begins to look like this was a robbery, Mr. Hardesty. It was a thief covering himself by blowing up the place.
Which would make it murder as well as robbery.
That's right. I don't have an idea in the world as to who might have done it.
I have an idea. I have a good idea.
No, Mr. Hardesty, no.
I'm sorry, young lady, but murder is murder.
But I told you about my brother was in confidence.
I can't condone murder, Miss Carlyle. No matter under what condition I heard your story.
What is this?
I know of a suspect, Marshal.
No, Mr. Hardesty, don't tell him.
The man who's hiding up in the Rim Rock country. He was accused of a post office robbery in Dodge City only a few weeks ago.
But he didn't do it. I explained about that to
him. And I'm afraid I can no longer accept your story.
Want to get a posse started, Marshal?
I guess we'd better. Start robbing up men, Pete.
All right.
Matt, we'll go. How about it, Hoppy? You know that Rim Rock country?
Well, all right, Marshal.
Mr. Cassidy, you're my only hope. There's something we've got to see before you go. Please come to Borden House. I can give you proof about my brother.
But the way it looks.
Please.
All right. Marshal, I'll need a few minutes.
All right, Hoppy. We'll be gathering in front of the saloon, the Texas. Don't take long. The sooner we start, the better chance we have of coming up with that fella.
Maybe he can be talked out of fighting. I'd better take off my gun. You know, my pipe will stand for guns coming into our house.
I have the letter upstairs, Mr. Cassidy. If you wait in the parlor. You will wait, won't you?
Sure, I'll wait.
Come on, you're holding up the along, Damon, in just a few minutes.
You ain't got nothing to do that's that important. Hey, you ain't wearing your guns.
Nobody wears guns in this house. My pipe won't. On your mind, Dameron.
So you ain't wearing guns. You don't think I'm going to pass up a chance like this, do you?
Meaning what?
I'm a deputy marshal. All legal-like. I was sent to bring you over to the posse. Now, if you say you won't come, you're resisting an officer, and that gives me the right to...
I haven't said I wouldn't come.
I didn't hear it that way, Cassidy. I didn't hear it that way at all.
Miss Fikes,
they
keeping you busy?
You too,
I might be able to talk my way out of it.
You're doing a lot to me, Cassidy. I won't forget it. My sister won't forget it either.
Maybe we'll all be lucky. I'll see you.
Hello,
to get here and really hide that box.
No, not good enough for that. It's still in the house, Hawkins.
They'll find it.
They will if you tell them.
I have to tell them, Matt. It's another man's life.
Or mine.
I've had to think about that, too. The fact that we've been friends.
You haven't asked me why I did it.
That's your affair.
If it weren't for Carlisle, you wouldn't concern yourself.
Carlisle and Lige Watson.
Lige has lived most of his life, Hawkins. His kids can get away. I'll help him.
And you and I never look each other in the eye.
Five feels many things, Hawkins.
It wouldn't help young Carlisle. He spent his life a hunted man.
I had to do it, Hawkins. I was jammed with
you. You couldn't help that. I can't help this.
There are stronger things than justice. I'm your friend.
I find it hard to believe, man. Holding a shotgun across your face.
Self-preservation, Hawkins. It's the strongest force in the world.
Even stronger than friendship, man?
Even stronger than friendship. I'm sorry, Hawkins, but I'm afraid you've made it a matter of you or me. So...
Oh!
You got me. You were too fast, after all.
You're not badly hurt.
Why,
no, Matt. Make another move with that shotgun and I'll have to kill you.
There for 30 minutes and never even got my ammo. Thank you. Oh, look at it. Isn't it so beautiful? It's... Oh, it's a one-star. American black man. Oh my god, this vicious animal. This golf sucks. Okay, I knocked it out for you. It's unconscious. Oh, it's still alive. You must be very careful around this deadly beast. He won't do it. bullshit, isn't it?
Thank you. You're an imbecile.
A what?
An idiot.
I'm sorry. He said he wouldn't run away.
Shut up.
But
please.
But
just shut up. They're gonna fire me. Oh, you get to keep your job, but they'll fire me, and they've got every right to fire me, because I'm the idiot who employed you. Oh, look. Guests. Are you a moron, partner? Huh? Well, you can't be any worse than us, because this idiot right here, just let the most notorious con man in the whole goddamn state walk clean out of a cell, clean out, and not a shot fired. Now, if you can get him back for us, we'll happily pay you. How about that? Good. Good. Now, see, what I figure is he's headed on down to Pike's Basin, so you go down the canyon, and you get him, and I'm gonna beat this poor dumb bastard with a stick, and I'll try and join you on the other side. Come on.
You fucking piece of shit trash can. That's okay, I'll just report you. I'm just live streaming right now, you bitch. Left players. Dipshit.
Well, I'd say it's good report. For you folks found each other.
Disruptive behavior. Oof.
And me, in need of friends, which right now, I don't.
Fucking die, I don't care. I'll run into a fucking...
What? Come on!
I hate people. People suck ass.
Thank you.
Let me go. Let me go. I've got money. I've got a lot of money. And I'll pay. I'll pay a lot. Hey, here's an idea. Take my hat. Put it on the dead guy over there. You take him in, as me, I go free, and you get rich. Oh, and I won't kill anybody else. I swear, I'm reformed. I'm a changed man. Please, please, I'm begging you, set me free. Have a heart.
So you don't get paid more if you take the deal than double cross them anymore? That's funny. I bet you do. Did that seriously just happen?
You better hope this rope holds.
Fine. Take me in then. You're too dumb to know a good deal when you hear one.
What are you doing, you goofy?
Right.
So you got him? Good. Real good.
Look.
Put him up on my horse there.
I didn't do
There's
nothing.
The money I promised you. It's nice seeing you again, buddy.
Name your price.
It's gonna be even nicer.
I've got money.
Watching you die.
I've got a lot of money. Just name your price and I'll make you rich.
Oh, do be quiet.
Come on, boy. See you later.
What's up?
Thank you.
Tranquilizer darts that don't work, that's good.
All right, that's it.